Hello students and welcome to the class of economics. Now today we again continue with same chapter 2. Now there are some topics which were left in this chapter that we are going to finish today. That is, this is part 5th, that is 5th video of chapter 2. Now these are the things which we are going to do, that is real GDP, nominal GDP, some aggregates, some activities which are excluded from GDP. When we say excluded means what are included in gross domestic product. That is, whenever we are going to calculate GDP at market price or factor cost, whatever things which are included that we have discussed earlier. Now today only we will discuss what are excluded from GDP and does GDP measure social welfare. That is, does GDP measure social welfare or not, and about deflators. Okay. Now starting with the first topic, that is national income at constant prices. As you all know that whenever we are going to calculate national income, it can be calculated in either constant price or either current price. When it is constant price, then it is called as real, okay. When it is calculated as current price, it is always nominal. And when we try to calculate at constant price, say for example, there are 5 to 6 years time period, okay, we wanted to calculate national income, then we need to calculate it on the basis of the base year. Okay, now what is base year is, all those 5 to 6 years time period, one particular year we are going to take, that will be called as a base year. On the basis of that, we are going to calculate national income at constant price, okay. So if national income is calculated on the basis of base year, that is, as I said, base year, any one year we are going to take, base year, price index, then it is known as national income at constant price. That is, when we are going to calculate national income at base year, then it is called as national income at constant price. Or it is also called as real national income. That means when we are going to calculate national income at constant price or on the basis of one base year, then it can also be called as real national income, as it fluctuates due to fluctuation of flow of goods and services which are produced in a country or in a nation. That is, whatever goods and services which are flowing, because of that there are certain fluctuation in the market price. Okay, so besides all this fluctuation, we are going to calculate the national income at constant price. Now national income at current price, when we say current price means they are taking care of the current year. Say for example, this is 2020. So if we are going to calculate national income, we are taking the current year, that is 2020. So if national income is calculated on the basis of current year price index, then it is known as national income at current price. It is also known as monetary national income. Just like national income, when we are going to calculate at constant price, it is called as real national income. When we are going to calculate national income at current price, it is known as monetary national income, as it fluctuates due to the fluctuation of flow of goods and services. That means these prices going to fluctuate as the flow of goods and services or production of goods and services keep on moving in the nation, along with the prices of the commodity. That means the prices of the commodity may fluctuate with the flow of goods and services in the country. Third is GNP at current price. Now GNP here means gross national product at current market price. We are going to calculate it at current price also and at constant price also. When final goods and services included in gross national product, that means all final goods and services, that is whatever productions takes place in one financial accounting year in a geographical boundaries, within the geographical boundaries of the country. So whatever goods and services, final goods and services which are produced, we are going to include it in gross national product and are valued at current market price. That means these goods and services are valued, are taken care at market price. That is, price is prevailing in the year for which GNP is being measured. That is, that price which is prevailing in that current year. Okay, current year like this 2020. Whatever prices are there, whatever prices are marked for those goods and services which are produced in that particular year, we are going to include it in gross national product. It is also called as GNP at current price, market price, or nominal gross national product, or either we can call it nominal gross national product. Now GNP at constant market price, we discussed GNP, the third point, at current price. Now GNP, gross national product, at constant market price, when final goods and services included in gross national product, that means we are going to include the final prices of final goods and services which are produced in a particular nation included in GNP are valued at constant price, that is prices of the base year, one base year. It is also called as GNP at constant market price, or we can call this real GNP, that is real gross national product. As I said earlier, whenever we are going to take at constant price, it is always termed as real. Okay, whenever we are going to take at the base year, any base year, okay, then we can call it a GNP at current market price, or we can call it nominal GNP. Now GNP deflator, when we talk about deflator here means it is a kind of measure, the average, the level of the prices of all the final, that means it is a kind of measure which is actually calculating the value of prices of all goods and services which are produced in a particular nation. So we can call it deflator measures the average level of the prices. What is the average level of the price? We are going to calculate with the help of GNP deflator of all the final goods and services which are produced within the domestic borders of the country, that is within the geographical area of the country in one financial year, including NFIA, that is net factor income from abroad. We are going to include this in GNP deflator. That is, whenever we are going to calculate GNP with the help of deflator, which is a measure, then we need to include the net factor income from abroad. GNP deflator is measured as the ratio of nominal GNP to real GNP. That is, what is the ratio of real, that is nominal to real GNP. That ratio, when we are going to calculate, we need deflator and multiplied by 100. And this is the formula to calculate GNP deflator. We need nominal GNP divided by real GNP into 100. When we say nominal, it is always at current price. When we say real, it is always at constant price. Now, what is green GNP? You have heard this word green. When we say green, it is a sign of positivity. Okay, some benefit, profit or positivity. So when we say GNP is green or green GNP, it refers to GNP adjusted for the loss of value. That means the value of gross national product is adjusted somewhere with the loss of certain value. And the loss of this value can be because of environmental degradation. That means because of environmental pollution or any kind of degradation which has been done, okay, not upgradation, degradation when it is done, because of that certain goods and services lost their value, their actual value. So this happens here. Second is depletion of natural resources. When we say depletion means is about to finish, that is certain natural resources which are depleted, which are finished on account of overall production activity in the economy. That means whatever production was actually taking place, but certain natural resources which lost their value because of depletion of those natural resources. Those natural resources are no more. Okay. So because of environmental degradation or depletion of natural resources, whatever value which is being adjusted, that can be called as green GNP. Okay. Now, seventh is activities which are excluded from GDP. As I said earlier before starting the video, that we are going to include whatever is included in GDP. We have mentioned this in earlier videos. Okay. Now, this is the activities which are excluded from GDP while calculating GDP at market price. So, the activities are purely financial transactions. That means any kind of transaction which are purely financial based. And it may be of three types. It can be buying and selling of securities. When we say securities, it means shares and bonds. Okay. Government transfer payments, private transfer payments. Now we will learn this one by one. The first is buying and selling of securities. As I said, securities means when the firm is buying or selling their shares or bonds. In financial markets, potential savers and investor. When we say potential means those savers or investors who have the capacity of having funds so that they can invest or they can save somewhere, either in stock exchange or either they can invest somewhere. So in financial markets, potential savers and investors buy and sell the securities or financial assets such as shares and bonds. Those shares and bonds, which are actually termed as securities for the firm or industries or for the financial market, these are financial assets for the investors. While someone buys a share, that means some person, some people who are buying a share, there is only a transfer of ownership. That is, when you are buying a particular share, it is only the transfer of ownership from the firm's name to the shareholders' names. So it is always a transfer of ownership from one person to another person. It is a claim to ownership of asset. That means by which the person, that is the shareholder, he will be called as the owner of that financial asset. That financial asset will be the shares or the bonds which he is purchasing from a particular financial market. Now, trading in financial instrument, this is the second aspect, does not imply production of final goods and services. That is, whatever trade which is taken place for all final goods and services, we are not going to include it as such. These are not included in the GNP. That means whatever trading in financial instrument means shares, bonds, whatever trading, buying and selling is being done, does not imply production. That means this is not production. The financial assets or the financial asset for one person, that is shareholder, or whatever shares or bonds which are issued by the any company or in the financial market, which is not termed as production of goods and services. That means it will not be included in GNP. Government transfer payment, the second topic. When we say transfer payment, it's obvious. When we say transfer payments, that means there is no production of goods and services taken place. It's just that it is coming from or transferred from one account to another without giving any productive services. Just like you are getting gifts from your parents or any kind of gift or allowances, pensions, okay, or any kind of benefits which the government employees are taken or taking or are given by certain job place or certain government services, they are giving pensions or such kind of allowances to their employees. This is called as transfer payment. That is, without doing any productive services, if some amount is transferred to your account or you are receiving a payment, that can be called as a transfer payment. So transfer payments are payments for which goods and services are provided in exchange. That means in which there is no goods and services which are provided in exchange. If I am receiving the payment, I am not giving any services to the employer. Still I am getting some payment that can be called as my pensions or any other things. So pension payments, employees, social security measures, that means either it can be the payment of for pension or it can be any kind of social security schemes which is introduced by the government to their employees, etc., are examples for transfer payments. As there is no production of final goods and services in response to those transfer payments, that is, in response to those transfer payments which I am receiving. Say, for example, if I am a government employee, okay, whatever I am receiving as transfer payment, I am not giving any services right now, because I am at my retirement age, say for example. So whatever I am receiving, I am not giving any productive services for that production of either goods or services. But still I am receiving, that can be called as a transfer payment. Third is private transfer payment. Okay, now this is also transfer payment. It is not government based. It is private transfer payments. Items such as pocket money, like I said, you people are getting the pocket money from your parents. Okay, any kind of gift on your birthdays or any other occasion, whatever money or whatever gift which you are receiving, that can be called as private transfer payment. Without giving anything to your parents, you are receiving those gifts. Okay, so items such as pocket money given by parents to their children, elder gifting money, your grandparents or your uncle, aunt are giving you some gifts to the young ones, are private transfer payment. This is merely a transfer of money. That means by this act, they are merely transferring the amount or transferring the money from their account to your account. That is, from one individual to another. That's it. This is not included in gross national product. That means without involving in any productive services, if you are receiving something as a gift, it will not be called as production of goods and services. No productive services is been done. So it will not be included in gross national product. Then second is transfer of used goods. When we are transferring the used good, that is, it can be second hand goods. Okay, if you have purchased a second hand bike from someone, okay, already that bike, whenever it was purchased in some previous years, it was actually included in the accounts. Okay, so if we are adding it again, when the second person, that is you, if you are purchasing that bike as second hand goods, again you don't need to use that amount into or write that amount into your account. Why? It will be duplication of the amount then. That is, the repetition will be done. Like GNP refers to the value of the final goods and services produced in a given year. That is, all those final goods and services which are produced in the year, GNP is going to include that. Hence, goods produced in the previous time period, that means those goods which are produced in some previous year's time period, cannot be included in the GNP. Okay. For example, Mr. A sales his bike, just like I gave an example, Mr. A who sales his bike to Mr. B for rupees 30,000 on 25th of April 2011. That means when Mr. A is selling his bike to Mr. B, surely that bike he has purchased in some previous year. Say for example, which was purchased by Mr. A on 1st March 2010. That means that bike which Mr. A have already purchased in 2010, it was actually included in the accounts. That means that amount. Again, if he is going to sell after 1 year, that is in 2011, if he is going to sell this bike to Mr. B at 30,000 rupees, this transaction should not be included as it has already been included in the books of accounts as 45,000 which he has purchased the bike in the 2010 GNP. And if we again include it, that means if in 2011 if he again include the amount, okay, then it will create the problem of double counting because it will be repetition which will be done. Now some non-market goods and services. When we say non-market goods and services, means all those goods and services which are not there for marketing purpose. That is, they are not supposed to be sold in the market. Say for example, in your garden, if you are growing certain vegetables for your family consumption, that will not be included because you are not going to sell those vegetables in the market. It is for your family consumption, for your self consumption. So these kind of activities or these kind of production of goods as well as services, when it is done for your self consumption, it will not be included in GNP. Say for example, many final goods and services are not acquired through regular market. That means there are certain goods and services which you are not purchasing from the regular market or no transaction is being done. Like vegetables can be grown in the backyard. That means the vegetables you can grow in your backyard, in your garden, instead of buying them from the supermarket or from the any vegetable vendor. Or an electrical fault can be repaired by the house owner. That means if there is any electrical fault, okay, at your home, something has been done, you are not calling an electrician. Besides calling an electrician, your father or your grandparents or somebody else, the house owner, if he is repairing it by himself, then he will not be charged for it and himself instead of hiring an electrician. So these kind of expenses or costs will not be included in GNP. These are examples of non-marketed goods and services that have been consumed with using organized market. That means these particular things or these particular goods and services which are used by organized market, as GNP includes only those transactions that occur through proper marketing activities. That means gross national product, we are going to include only those activity which are actually marketed for the purpose in the regular market. That means those goods and services which are actually sold in the regular market, or either we are purchasing it from the regular market, not for self-consumption. Then some illegal activities. If I would say illegal activities means gambling or stealing something. So all this unlawful activities or illegal activities will not be included in GNP. Activities like gambling, black marketing, etc. should be excluded because all unlawful activities are beyond the scope of national income. That means we are not going to include these illegal activities or the funds which are coming from these illegal activities in calculating the national income, and also because there is statistical problem of their estimation. That means we are actually practically we are facing some problems of estimation through statistics when we are using it. Then leisure time activities. Leisure time means when you are free, you are busy in sketching something, you are busy in gardening, you are busy in preparing food, that is cookery or any other things. So activities like painting, growing of flowers in kitchen, garden, etc. is not included as their aim is not to earn money. Because these activities you are involved in or you are doing it just because these are your hobbies or this can be your leisure time hobby or a part-time things, okay. You are not doing all these activities like gardening, painting or all these activities for earning money, okay. It is not economic activities, these are only non-economic activities. like free time in one's hobby or entertainment. That means if you are in free time, busy in some your hobbies, fulfilling your hobbies or any entertainment activities, again there is statistical problem of measuring. That means we will be facing certain estimation problem through statistical measures. And their satisfaction derived in painting, that is whatever satisfaction which you are deriving from painting the things, that means that is your inner satisfaction. You are not earning money out of those leisure activities or leisure time activities or any other leisure activities. So we are not going to include these leisure time activities or illegal activities in calculating the GNP. So these are some of the things which are excluded while calculating gross national product. So dear student, that's it. Now today we have actually finished the chapter also, all the terms, all the concepts we have already finished. Now moving to the next chapter, and before that we are going to calculate the national income. Whatever numericals which are given in this chapter, we are going to calculate in the next video. Till then, thank you.